Welcome to Liberate Your People Pleaser. I am your host, Brenda Florida, certified life coach, and you might be a people pleaser if you sacrifice your needs or your wants or your feelings to benefit someone else, or you keep silent when something bothers you or upsets you, or you're super critical and feel like you're probably your own worst enemy. Well, here's what I've got in store for you for this podcast. First of all, there's nothing wrong with you and you don't need fixing. What we need to do is leverage the superpowers of being a people pleaser, because there are definite superpowers. You are super intuitive, I am sure. You have great powers of empathy, the ability to read a situation and know what's going on with people and those around you. So what we're going to do in each episode is talk about ways to disempower the parts of it that are diminishing and don't serve us anymore, and level up or empower all those superpowers. So join me in the next episode of Liberate Your People Pleaser. The Gift of Rebellion. What a crazy title, huh? Well, I'm here to tell you that I think rebellion can be a great gift in our lives. And here's what I mean. You know, as people pleasers, we so often get stuck in sort of rigid ways of expressing ourselves and being in the world, where we're overly invested in what other people think about us, or we're overly attached to whatever the rules or the kind of construct of our life tends to be, so that we feel like we can't do things that other people, you know, get to do or whatever. And we're so busy seeking the approval of others, or not wanting to upset somebody, or not wanting to rock the boat or whatever, we sort of lose our power in that. Well, in a way, rebellion is a great way to pull your power back, okay? Because even though rebellion is not a place we necessarily want to stay, right? We want to find our truth. That's what we're going for. We want to find our truth. And as people pleasers, our truth has often been so buried or so covered up, is a lot of times how I like to think of it. It's like, because it's always there. That's why I'm always saying, like, there's nothing we need to fix and there's nothing broken about us because we're people pleasers or whatever. What's happened is that our truth of who we are and how we would naturally express ourselves because of who we are through our authentic, unique divine nature gets covered up. Like, if you just think of it as layers and layers of like blankets that get covered up over that, to where we can't even see it. Okay. And that's why we get lost. Like the episode a few weeks ago, where I was talking about how I had forgotten what my favorite color was. Like, I was looking to my husband to tell me what my favorite color was when a therapist asked me. So that's what people pleasing does. I mean, that might be a more dramatic example than you have in your life, but many of us have hidden or buried the truth of who we are so deeply that we kind of don't even know what it is. We're so used to being a people pleaser, we don't know what it's like not to be. And so therefore we can end up being in that place where we think, well, this is just who I am. Like, I've coached people on that and they think, well, this is just who I am. I'm super thoughtful to other people, or I just love to serve or whatever, because there are a lot of habits that are connected to people pleasing that are very applauded by the outside world, right? You're always putting yourself second. So that can be associated with being, you know, really being of service. Well, truly being of service means I take care of myself first and I give out of abundance. I don't give out of a sense of I'm not worthy to put myself first, or it's wrong to put myself first, or that might upset someone, or I need to keep my mouth shut and not speak the truth because I don't want to rock the boat. So those are the kinds of distortions that get set up in us as people pleasers. And so what rebellion can do is like fling off some of those blankets that end up covering up our truth. And sometimes, frankly, that's just the best way to get out of that limiting thought process or that limiting habit that we've been in, and just fling it off, rebel, go to the other end of the spectrum, so to speak, right? So maybe you get to what feels like to you is super selfish, right? Like you're not going to cook dinner for the next 3 weeks, or you're not going to do the laundry, or you're not going to, like, I don't know, whatever it is that you over, you know, produce in the ways that you over function for your family. And of course, this happens to men as well as women, that, you know, we get into these patterns of over functioning, which allow the people around us to under function. Okay, whether it's at work or at home, whatever. And so maybe you kind of go on strike for a while. That's the rebellion. And that's not where you're going to stay. But you need to get there to break that habit, right? To break the habit of always being the servant, to break the habit of always putting yourself second, to break the habit of always thinking how somebody else feels and not wanting to upset them is more important than you being able to say what has upset you, to say what you are feeling. So sometimes we just need to rebel in order to get to the more sort of truthful place. I don't want to really use the word balance, because this isn't about balance. Being a people pleaser is about having our truth stifled out of us, shut down so many times in so many ways that we can have trouble even finding it. So if you need to throw it all off and go a little crazy for a while, you know, maybe it's only in one area of your life. Maybe it's in a whole bunch of areas of your life. This is where, like, that fantasy, I've had the fantasy often that I would, you know, leave when my kids were at home and stuff, just this idea of, I'm just going to leave. I'm going to take a sabbatical and I'm going to go sit on a beach for a month or something and just take that break. Right. That's kind of that rebellion. If you can't do it, like I couldn't, I was a single mom, I couldn't leave my children. But then that's your idea, right? So let that be the spark. Let that idea of the rebellion, even if you don't do it, be the spark of, okay, this is clearly a signal that I need more time for myself. I need more space for myself. How can I start to find the truth of what my needs are, what my desires are, and how I can start expressing them, maybe what it is, or meeting those needs, getting those needs met? Because that rebellion can really help take us to the truth, because that truth is what's buried under all those habits of diminishment and putting yourself second and prioritizing everybody else's wants and needs over your own, everybody else's feelings over your own. So I'm just super curious if you can think of a time that that kind of rebellion has ended up really serving you. And yeah, maybe there were a few prices to pay along the way, but you know, we get so hung up. The other thing I really want to leave you with today is this idea to let go of any shame or guilt or judgment around these periods of rebellion, or anything else for that matter, because guilt and shame and rebellion, judgment, never serve us. Rebellion can serve us, but guilt and shame and judgment do not. We have been conditioned for generations, a lot of it out of various religious structures, but not just that, not limited to that, that somehow if we didn't feel guilty about something, if we didn't feel shame for certain behaviors, if we weren't self-judging and other judging, but we'll talk about self-judging today, then what? We're going to go crazy. We'd all become murderers. We'd all go to school naked. We'd all, you know, whatever. That's my mother used to say that all the time when, you know, fashion, like, you know, I'm a kid of the 70s. So I suppose it was midriff tops and bell bottom pants or something I wanted to wear. And in short skirt, I loved wearing short skirts, short dresses when that was the thing. And my mother would be like, soon you're going to be going to school naked, you know? So it's this setup for as if without guilt and judgment, we would just do all this crazy shit. And the truth is you won't, because even if you go into rebellion for a little while, like whatever, the judgment over that or the shame over that, it's just not going to serve you. Look at it as like this guide that was like, okay, I needed to swing a little bit that way so I could come back over here in the center and find my truth. Because this distortion over here and people pleasing, that wasn't my truth either. That's what other people wanted me to believe or to see about myself, a way of being in the world. But that's not the truth either. So who cares if I had to go, you know, wild for a little bit so that I could really find what is my truth. So I'd love to hear how rebellion has served you in your life. And if you're able to let go of any sort of guilt or judgment, whether it's over the rebellion or other things, because I end up coaching so many people who have stories from their past or something they've done, their, you know, a habit or a behavior they're in now, overspending. Like that's what I used to do, a lot of overspending. Particularly as I was coming into like, what do I really like, right? Once I remembered what my favorite color is, I realized so much of what I was buying for clothes, you know, like my wardrobe and the things in my house and whatever were based on what other people styles or, you know, ideas that other people liked or that I saw on other people. And so I was just copying them instead of really looking at myself and my own individuality and saying, you know, what do I want? What do I like? So my rebellion and some of that was I overspent, I overshopped, but it helped me figure out what I really love. And so, yeah, I had to pay off the credit cards, you know, but it helped me get to a place where I could express my own truth in my home furnishings and my clothing, you know, all kinds of different ways we express ourselves out in the world. So I'd love to hear how this is for you. If you're able to let go of that guilt, if you're able to see how a rebellion has served you, if you're dying to feel free enough to have a rebellion, you know, like you're just like, oh, if only I could. So let me know. Let me know in the comments. If you, you know, depending on wherever you're seeing this, let me know in the comments or email me and let's chat about it, because I would love to hear how rebellion has been a gift for you or how rebellion might be a gift you'd like to receive. All right. Thank you for joining me for this episode of Liberate Your People Pleaser. Hey, I've got three more things for you. One is join my private Facebook group, Liberate Your People Pleaser. We have lots of great conversations. I do Facebook Lives in there, drop in free resources, all kinds of cool things to support you in your journey to liberate your people pleaser. So the link for that is in the show notes. Second, I would love it if you would put a 5-star review on whatever podcast service that you found the podcast on. That would be totally awesome. And I'll give you a shout out on a future episode. And last but not least, if you've got a question you would like for me to answer or address, you'll also find a link in the show notes to do that. So submit your question and you'll hear me talk about it on a future episode of Liberate Your People Pleaser. I'll see you in the next episode, everyone. Bye-bye.